ready. That lingering rot is gone out of the air.
I feel better. The weight's been lifted.
Just when I think this land holds no more surprises, I find myself in some... Still.
Well, have you found the cause of this aura? This shroud?
She slinks forward until her face is mere inches from your own.
I owe you a debt. But I already know what you desire. And I intend to pay in full. Right now. Tell me, do you know exactly what I am? In a manner of speaking, my dear, but I am so much more. I am a succubus. Love is my power. It enthralls those who I seduce and feeds me yet more power. It is through this aspect of myself that I must reward you.
You realize that her hand is caressing your arm. She gazes at you intently. Her eyes are oceans of violet. You could drown in them.
You have my word, though. I will not use my powers to make you my thrall. Just as I hope you won't use what I show you to become some sort of tyrant.
She grins devilishly and pulls you close.
Let's see what you're made of.
She kisses you. She defies. Suddenly she's all blinding light and come hither heat. Her heat enters you, thrust upon thrust, until she scalds, and with a scream, her nails digging for blood, all becomes an echo of the primal soul, a burst of overwhelming white. Slowly the heat abates as she releases you with a kiss. Your vision swims back into view, Almira observing you with a knowing smile.
My, my. That was intense, wasn't it? Truth be told, there was nothing really left to teach you, but I felt it would be rude to stop once we got going. You were ever so satisfying, though. Please, accept this little token of appreciation for your effort. Once you've caught your breath, I actually have another little request for you. You have helped me to escape immediate danger, but I remain a fugitive from my old life and the promises I made to it. The Black Ring swear allegiance to a powerful being, the God King. This is not a mere oath of duty, this is the covenant. And those who accept it are bound to the God King. They are sworn. I am sworn. You have to understand, Lucien's death fog broke us. We were left defeated, leaderless. And then the God King started to speak to us. He offered victory, immortality, anything we desired in exchange for loyalty. How could we refuse? Once you are sworn, there is no escape. Your life is the God King's. Fail or betray him, and you are doomed. Unless you find a way to break the covenant. That is where you come in, my dear. I discovered the existence of ancient implements called Swornbreakers. They are rumored to be able to break any magical pact, including the Covenant. And while enslaved by the Magisters, I noticed a tablet in their excavation site in the Black Pits. It bore markings that looked very similar to how these Swornbreakers were described to me.
She smiles, fixing those violet eyes upon you once again.
Will you retrieve it for me? He is a god for the godless, a beacon for those who have no place in this world. He seeks to cast down the world of the Seven and build a new world with the Sworn at his side. The Black Ring flock to him after Lucien unleashed his death fog. The undead stand by him because he offers them a return to life. I don't know why the Voidwoken flock to him. But I want to be with Mahali. That is why the God King and I must part ways. That is why I need a Swornbreaker.
My, you are a special one, aren't you?
Well, that settles it then. I will join you, and I guarantee we will find use for each other in the future.
By the by, a black little birdie told me you have a ship along the shore. That is where we'll go. Enjoy a bit of sun while we wait for you to conclude your business along Reaper's Coast. In the meantime, have a little token as a thank you for all that you've done for me so far.
keeping it together,
Glad to see you well. Anything more? Until later, then.
Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Then don't come over. I don't want your boy anything.
If I don't come visit you, Tug, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
See you well. Anything more? Until later, then.
Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Prices are up, quality is down. Times are tough.
If I don't come visit your tongue, who will?
Back for a return visit, are you?
Have at it. Got yourself situated.
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right. As long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it.
Yep.
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it.
Cat and the dog appear to be arguing.
Moo! Moo!
The animals argue on.
Dog! Dog!
Can't win, can I?
The animals argue on.
Dog.
Oh.
Dog.
Can't win, can I?
The animals argue on.
Dog.
Oh.
Dog.
Can't win, can I?
The cat and the dog appeared.
Boo!
Oh.
The cat and the dog still.
Boo!
The cat and the dog still.
Boo!
Salamander's tongue flicked. The chest before you is covered in old ancient empire pictograms. You consider trying to find some lock picks in your bag, but looking at the chest, you don't see any keyhole. You hear a deep rumbling from inside the chest, and a voice emerges. It hisses and clicks, but doesn't make any sense. The chest's chatter gets louder and angrier. It refuses to open.
To see an elf burning the body of kin, it turns one's stomach.
The ghost takes a step back in fear as sauce pours from your body. The lizard tries to slash at it with her claws, but they pass through it like smoke.
You're like him. You're no better than the elf, you monster! You beast!
The salamander's tongue flickers. As you approach, the salamander turns its head away, twisting its snout into the air. It refuses to even look in your direction. The chest before you is covered in old ancient empire pictures. You hear a deep rumbling from inside the chest, and a voice emerges. The chest's chatter gets...
Worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a...
the best.
Well, there's a fun face. Byron and I are patching up before we head home. Hope the Order folks are treating you all right. You stay out of trouble now.
Come on, can't I go and play with the others?
No can do, Chickadee. You're not leaving my sight for a while longer yet.
But Ma...
No can do, Chickadee. You're not...
But, Ma... Come on, can't I go and play with the others?
You want an engraved invitation every time? You know the way in. An engraved invitation every time. You know the way in.
Good to see you again, Governor. Heard you're the new champion. Well done, I say. Take all the time you need. Pleasure doing business with you, Governor. Hail, such a striking man.
She draws close. You feel her breath on your neck, hot, moist.
Oh, yes. Are you worthy of my gift? Very well. But you'll be back, and I'll be right here.
The tigers fly, the leopards lie, and you, oh, but I know you, don't I? I have seen you in the night, a lone man in a wicked fog. Just a dream, of course, just a dream.
She smirks. She's definitely not smiling with you. The dwarf looks right through you, no interest whatsoever in making your acquaintance.
Bugger off. Can't you see I'm trying to relax? Pout? What pout? Oh, that was you. Yes, yeah, sorry, bub, but I was pulling your crank. There ain't any pout. I just wanted to distract you while I nipped a little gold out of your pocket. Needed a fix. Sorry. Now, like I said, please kindly bugger off. It's turned to smoke by now. Go ahead and take it from my flesh if you want. I don't care.
I can't use that right now.
It seems I can't use that right now.
Mm-hmm.
No go. Not now, at least.
No go. Not now, at least.
Use that right now.
No go.
Not now, at least.
You'll have to let me buy you an ale sometime.
Impressive. There's...
Thank you.
How's my f-
Ifan claps you on the shoulder.
You're the challenger who finally defeated Murga, aren't you? Why, I'm honored.
Good riddance to Murga. Her and her bloody pet Voidwoken had...
Impressive. Dare say the spirit of the one stronger in you than anyone else I've seen. Even Murga.
What is it? I have a lot on my mind.
He nods at the satchel on the table with a smile and gestures for you to help your...
That's right. Lost one of my best luck. We will. Once the Reds... That's... Well, I reckon that's good news. Poor... Whatever needs to...
Thank you.
Second time's a charm? Or have I asked too much of you?
a long time. Not since before I joined the Magisters.
Be on your way now, my dear. Perhaps we'll have matters to discuss again later.
Second time's a charm? Or have I asked too much of you? Second time's a charm? Or have I asked too much of you?
Try as he might, Tarquin cannot hide a small flash of surprise.
Where did you hear that precisely? Never mind. The Aetherian is a children's fable, nothing more. Supposedly a wand with an infinite capacity for source. Pure nonsense, I assure you. Really? Well, perhaps that says more about the caliber of their intellect than anything else. Such a device would be a gross overconcentration of power. It could purge the entire world of all source. Luckily, the laws of the universe render such a thing impossible.
I do hope I've not been overestimating your intelligence. Anathema's blade. By the weapon's own admission, it's to be found somewhere on Blood Moon Island.
The blade quivers as Tarquin nears it and hums a response. An unfallen reveil. Amadio Vlucio de Anne Dritta Dumores.
Oh, very good. Very, very, very good. This, my friend, is the key. Give me some time, and every deity in existence will tremble at the sight of you.
He holds out his hand, expectantly.
Love. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must work.
Tarquin turns away, but continues to mutter excitedly, almost religiously, about Anathema.
Shame I had to leave the stone garden behind. I feel so at home among the graves.
For hire. Oh, I...
Do
Good to see you again. Marvelous ship you have here. Worthy of a king. She intrigues me greatly. I'd say it was brave of her to send you after a demon hunter, but bravery implies something to be feared. She's fearless.
Jahan deeply inhales the sea air and smiles contently.
Our mission has a name, Adramalik. He is the fiend that possesses you, but worry not. We'll find him, and we'll undo him. To the city of Arx we must go, where he disguises himself as Dr. Deva.
Aren't you supposed to be off learning how to become the divine and whatnot?
Her eyes flash with something. Anger, perhaps, or fear.
But never mind. We'd better focus on the task at hand.
She looks straight ahead, ignoring you.
I'd like to take a look at what I've been working on. Go on. By all means.
has not been.
You defy.
Thank you.
to none.
Reaper for me.